Project 3 will have Toastmaster result. The title of his speech is Time Travel. Time Travel, Toastmaster result.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you like to go back in time?
Yeah.
Would you like to relive your special moment again?
Yes.
Would you like to revisit all the exciting places that you have been in your lifetime?
Yeah.
Sure.
Would you like to be a time traveler?
Cool.
If the answer is yes, then you need to follow only three simple steps. First step, find a super billionaire to fund this project. Step number two, find a mad scientist to create your time machine. And the third step is, if you manage to go back in time, don't destroy my future. Ladies and gentlemen, this kind of time travel only exists in movies. Can you give me an example of time travel movies?
Back to the Future.
Back to the Future.
Yes.
Doraemon.
Okay. Okay. There's a lot of movies related to time travel. Anyway, let me tell you what I think. I don't believe that we can transport this body physically to any time, to anywhere. I don't believe that we can change the history. But I do believe that we can time travel mentally. The scientists call this method of time traveling mental time travel. It's a study of the brain remembering the past to predict the future outcome. So for those who are interested in this study, you can look into it in the internet. Let me share you my version of mental time travel. Can you remember what you're doing this morning? Okay, look, let me be more specific. What made this morning different than any other morning?
School reopen.
Big jam.
Get the children up.
Now, can you remember what you see, what you hear, what you smell, and what you touch this one? If you cannot do that, it is, don't worry, it's a normal thing, normal behavior. Because as we go on our daily routine, mundane routine, daily, day in and day out, we tend to ignore our surroundings. We unintentionally forget who we are. We take for granted that what is really happening every second of our life is that we are alive and the surrounding is alive too. But if you can remember this special morning, then in my opinion, you are a mental anchor. So, the keyword is unique, or special, or out of the ordinary. For some unknown reason, this kind of special event in our life, we can remember and relive over and over again. Now, if this morning is possible to time travel, then you can time travel mentally to your past and to live your special moment, your or your happy time. Okay. Let me give you my previous visit to the past. On the 1st June, I went back in time mentally 8 years ago to my wedding day. I can still remember my queen with her white, silky, pearly dress, smiling. And I can still feel the sensation and inside me that says, yes, woo, and score. And I still can remember my mother over there. I can see my father chatting. My brother's doing something. My cousin taking the picture. And that's it. And I found out that nobody in my hometown came to my wedding day. And then my hand become shaky. Little bit gritty, a little bit sandy. Then I remember that I just buried my dead grandmother a day before. So the question now is, why you want to time travel? Because the best time of your life is in the past. When you feel sad, you go back in time to feel happy again. When you have some marital problem, you come back to your wedding days and ask and question yourself, do you love her? Do you love him? And bring that feeling back to the current and present of your life. Ladies and gentlemen, it is possible to time travel, to live those special moments again. And if our past is the best time in our life, I say to myself today, I say to myself and to all of you, let's make this. We can make the current and the future even better than the past. And if we believe that we can do that, to have a happier life, happier career, happier future, then you just travel to the future mentally. And all you have to do now is bring yourself there in time. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have a wonderful and conscientious time back to paint time, and remember to come back to reality soon.